Does James Rodriguez still have the magic to light up the World Cup? This time last year, James Rodriguez was preparing to go on a preseason tour to China with his new Bayern Munich teammates, wondering why his dream move to Real Madrid had turned into such a nightmare. It had come to this. His time in Spain had gone so off script that he arrived in Munich a shadow of the player he was 3 years ago and with question marks looming over him. Rodriguez was so good at the World Cup in Brazil he was nicknamed King James, but there was no mention of royalty or rolling out of the red carpet when he turned up to join Carlo Ancelotti's squad. He made a shaky start, but eventually found solace in Bavaria, emerging from the dark and riposting critics with fine displays on the pitch. Now, he is planning to remind the world of his enduring quality against the backdrop of Colombia's snowy ski resort in Kazan ahead of their opening World Cup game against Japan. Jose Pekerman no doubt will be hoping he can conjure up performances similar to the 2014 World Cup in Brazil that inspired Colombia to reach the quarterfinals for the first time in history. If Rodriguez can light up the stage in Russia, the Colombia boss can give himself a pat on the back for a job well done. For it was Pekerman who convinced Rodriguez to leave Real Madrid in order to get regular game time and recapture his form. "I think it's very important for the World Cup to find a good rhythm," said Rodriguez recently. "I used to play at Monaco all the time before the World Cup in Brazil and now I play all the time at Bayern. I'm feeling good." Everything would suggest Rodriguez is clicking into gear just at the right time, but emulating his 2014 tournament is a tall order. It feels like a long time ago now and for him it will feel like a lifetime. It was the year the Colombia dazzled the world and subsequently found it laying at his feet after sealing a £60 million move to Real Madrid. Rodriguez was already making ripples around Europe as an upcoming talent before shining in Brazil, but it was his 6 goals, which included a stunning volley against Uruguay, in the World Cup that convinced the La Liga giants to come calling. It was a no-brainer. He immediately packed his World Cup Golden Boot award and headed from the independent city-state of Monaco to the sunny capital of Spain. He came bristling with optimism but 3 years later would leave with bindle in hand and a rooted feeling of depression. Despite making an auspicious start to his real career, scoring 17 times and chalking up 18 assists in his first season, things soon took a turn for the worst. Rafa Benitez's appointment to replace Ancelotti at the end of the 2014-15 season proved to be the beginning of his downfall. The Spaniard's first port of call was perhaps a telltale sign of how things would pan out under his reign: replace Rodriguez with Casemiro. Benitez didn't stick around long, though, and was out of Madrid's revolving doors before the end of the next season. Zinedine Zidane came in, Rodriguez's idol growing up, and continued the theme: keep Casemiro ahead of Rodriguez. Zidane deployed a 4-3-3 formation, meaning there was no space for a traditional no-10, Rodriguez's preferred position, and Madrid's midfield wasn't the most accommodating. Instead, Zidane was attracted by the versatility of Isco and Marco Asensio, with the former eventually becoming the polyvalent glue that held his team together. Rodriguez was casted as a supporting act and only completed the full 90 minutes on 8 occasions during the 2016-17 season. He was dropped from the squad altogether for their Champions League triumph over Juventus, which proved to be the final straw, but would never place blame on Zidane for his lack of game time. "It is incredible that a player of that level cannot play more often," Pekerman said last year. "For the sake of the Colombian national team, it is always good for James to have continuity. I expect things to change one way or another." Indeed, everything Colombia do runs through Rodriguez, so Pekerman got on the phone and urged him to leave with the 2018 World Cup very much in mind. Rodriguez joined Bayern on an initial 2-year loan deal last June, but he was not the same player as he was in Brazil when he first arrived. His time as a peripheral figure in Madrid had taken its toll and left him crippled with self-doubt. It was not until Jupp Heynckes replaced Ancelotti in October that Rodriguez began to slowly reclaim his mojo. Heynckes said in April, he was feeling depressed when he first came. "I took care of him, I had lots of talks with him, and step by step he found his confidence. The 26-year-old became a regular under Hanks and finished the season as a Bundesliga champion with 8 goals and 14 assists. He impressed so much in Germany that Bayern now looks set to trigger the £37 million purchase option this summer. But can King James sit atop the throne and dazzle on the biggest stage again for his country? It seems as though Rodriguez inadvertently set himself up for failure by netting 6 times in the 2014 tournament, a feat he is unlikely to repeat even with a solid season behind him, but something that is now expected of him. Make no bones, though, Rodriguez is exuding a breezy confidence once again and is in Russia to show everyone he hasn't lost his magic touch. He will have to battle pressure and expectation. Colombia's hopes are pinned on him. They have a rejuvenated Radamel Falcao, Tottenham's Davinson Sanchez and a pacey Juan Cuadrado, but it is Rodriguez who is Colombia's blue-eyed boy. And his teammates know it and accept it. He pulls the strings and dissects their opponents with his surgical left foot. He is the conductor of the Colombia orchestra. His free role position in midfield given to him by Pekerman is testament to that. Colombia are by no means in the frame to win the World Cup this summer, but if Rodriguez is firing on all cylinders in Russia, there is no telling how far they can go. A 3-2 friendly victory over tournament favorites France back in March, when Rodriguez sublimely set up Luis Muriel and Falcao, serves as a good indicator of what they are capable of. A 0-0 draw against Australia 4 days later and against Egypt earlier this month does the same job. It will depend on Rodriguez, as it typically does. The fact he has regained his self-belief in the past 6 months is only good news for Colombia and bad news for the rest of tournament nations. There is no denying that Rodriguez is back to his best and is confident of repeating his exploits in Brazil. The 26-year-old revels in his role as the main man and certainly still possesses the talent to sparkle on the world stage again. Expect fireworks, though an unprecedented successive Golden Boot looks a stretch too far.